प्रपन्न पारिजाताय तोत्र वेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञान मुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृत दुहे नमः। ओम नमो वेंकटेशाय। My best wishes and paripurna ashirvadams to all the viewers of Sri Venkateswara Bhakthi Channel. Harihi Om. Srimad Bhagavat Gita, second chapter, verse number 16. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha, Nasato Vidyate Bhavaha, Na Bhavo Vidyate Sataha, Ubhayorapi Drashtontaha, Tvanayostatvadarshibhihi. Lord Krishna is explaining the reality of the self, because Arjuna is suffering from unique problem. The problem is called samsara dukkham or bhavarogam. This samsara dukkham, or which is called bhavarogam, is a kind of unique disease which is common to entire creation. The solution for this suffering is paramarthika jnanam or adhyatmika jnanam. If we translate it, the knowledge of Supreme Self. That is the great remedy. And all kinds of problems which we face in our life, all of them can be removed by the knowledge about the self. Because we don't find the solution for the problems, we think towards out. Therefore what? It seems to be very difficult, because we count the problems from the childhood. And we also fix the cause of the problems, that which is in the outside world. So when I conclude that there is a problem, the cause of problem is something else which is outside. Now I have to hit that source from where the problem arises. Then I have to correct it. That's what the mentality which we have. Usually we have. Because mind and buddhi trained in that way. Now Gita, the Krishna says, look into you. Doesn't matter any problem. This samsara problem is the supreme one. All other problem which is caused by this lack of self-knowledge. It seems to be meaningless, valueless, effectless. But which is nothing but the truth is. That's what he says. This tattva darshi means the knower of truth. Who has realized both realities, which is in the form of I. Therefore, Arjuna is provided a supreme knowledge now. And this Krishna is using highly supreme one, by which he could gain even moksha. And also he will bring three categories which we saw in the last episodes. A problem can be approached from the angle of supreme knowledge, paramarthika drishti, philosophical angle. Then the next approach can be done as dharmika angle, ethical angle, which deals with dharma and adharma, and the same problem can be approached for the salvation with the angle which we call it practical angle, laukika drishti. Now, three of them are going to be introduced to Arjuna by Krishna. Now, first he gives the climax, that ultimate knowledge to be understood by every human being. That's what we are undergoing now. In the last session, we little bit understood what ahankara is. Because the beginning itself, second chapter introduced, there are two kinds of realities. One is called satyam, another is called asatyam. One is called nityam, another is called anityam. The same is called atma and anatma. These realities are experienced by me as myself. Now you see, this shastra has divided you into two reality. Because if I ask you, how do you experience about you? Then you will be confused. What the question is this. I experience myself as myself. No. Are you experiencing as the physical system? Do you experience? Do you feel that how weight you are? Means how much weight you are? If you are 80 kg or 100 kg or 50 kg, do you feel that heaviness? No, I don't feel the heaviness. But go and stand on the weighing machine. That machine will say how weight you are. Have you got the difficulty? Are you making some effort to carry 80 kg? No, sir. Then how you experience about you? Weightless? Or with the weight? Or the weight is not realized. Our weight also includes as the reality of the self. Now, I don't understand what you say. It means we don't understand our I with the weight. But Bhagavan Krishna says, there are two kinds of I, which is depending on the body, mind, sense complex with karma, is called ahankara, the small I. And one more I, which is completely free from this body, mind and sense complex, and which is the base for this I. That is one more reality. Now our choice relies here. I could understand, identify myself with the I which is endowed with body, mind, sense complex, or I can identify properly with the original I which is the base for everything. This ahankara which we understood in the last session, this ahankara alone lives the life. But this ahankara which doesn't have independence, it's not independent enough to be, to have proper existence. This ahankara which takes all the avatara. When we were born, we were called baby. Have you realized? Yes, I'm a baby, I'm a baby, I'm a baby. Did you understand? Did we understood it? Did we realize we are the babies? No. We got consciousness means, we get the conscious about the self after maybe 4 or 5 years later, when we went to school, we could feel that our individuality, yes, I am separate, slowly developed. That developed means identified with the body, mind and sense complex. When we studied, we were given a kind of state of students, that I am student, that's one ahankar. Okay, I am a school student, then I am a higher secondary school student, I am a college student, I am UG, PG. Then what? When you go to an office, according to the rank, if you are a manager, general manager, when you are given the state of general manager, you become general manager. That ahankara thinks that I am a general manager. That same ahankara, it plays role of a son to your father, as a husband to your wife, as a father to your son, and what? As a friend to your friend, as a well-wisher to your well-wishers. So like this ahankara, which wants lots of states, means we can call it a status or state. The given role it plays, it adapts that role. This all changes. But it won't get confused. Have you ever asked the question to your people that am I manager or your father? Have you asked to your son? We don't do this. Why? Because we are not confused. Because that ahankara which endowed with this karma, karma has the divisions. If you would have studied, means you would have studied engineering, you will become an engineer. If you would have studied for a doctor, you should become a doctor. You go along with the karma and result also enjoyed by you. Therefore what? You become author for karma, therefore you are called karta. And you become the enjoyer of karma too, then you become bhokta. Now this I which is endowed with kartrutva and bhoktrutva. Kartrutva means what? Doership. Bhoktrutva means what? Enjoyership. That's what we are. That's what I am. That's what we think. We identify ourselves with this I alone. The I which camouflages according to the situation, with the state, nothing wrong in it. But we have to identify ourselves. If I ask you, are you a manager? Are you a father? Are you a husband? Are you a son? Who are you? No, sir, I am. My name is Raghav. Okay, your name is Raghav. And more particular, a Raghav who is the father of your son, isn't it? Yes, sir. So, husband of your wife, isn't it? Yes, sir. Son of your father, isn't it? Yes, sir. That's what I'm asking. Among these all characters, who are really you? No, all of them, it's me. Wow. It's a proper understanding. How can you be with all the state? That's what the unique, because they are karma. That's what we never get confused. We never get confused, but when we ignored the original I, if you are lacking of the knowledge of the original I, this I gets confused because it loses itself, means ahankara loses itself, it gets confused, who am I? Because playing role as a husband, playing role as a son-in-law, it becomes very difficult. Now you are, that's what Arjuna also had the confusion. Am I a grandson to Bhishmacharya or am I an enemy to Bhishmacharya? Am I a student to Dronacharya? Am I an enemy to Dronacharya? That's what the confusion. This is a self-confusion. Therefore, you should know originally who you are. And this will help a lot in your life. And people may say, this knowledge, how will it help me to get out of my problems, company problems? Because nobody knows about the consciousness, what it is. Nobody knows there are two eyes. Nobody bothers it. If I come to know, how would I solve those problems because they are not aware about it? Don't bother about others. Because you are facing problems, suffering means you have a very much deep connection with those karma phala. Therefore, you have to realize yourself so that you could deal with your karma phala properly. That's what unique step we are taking now. Therefore, we have to study about ourselves. If we are lacking of one part of knowledge about ourselves, we cannot live ourselves because both should be realized well. Therefore, these words, it says, the Krishna says here, antaha, ubhayoho antaha api, tattva darshi vihi drashtaha. These both realities and difference between these both realities are understood by the knower of the truth. And not only that, they also know the truth of this reality, the fact of this reality. What is the truth of this reality? What is the fact of this reality? Because it says that among these two reality, one is endowed with real existence, another is endowed with false existence. Now, Krishna is very keen and serious with you because you experience, means we experience two reality that only we understand, others cannot understand, because others, they could understand their reality. Among these two realities which we experience, so one is existent, means one is existing with a proper existence. Another exists with a false existence or as the false existence. Now simply speaking, one is eternal reality, another is false reality. Real reality, false reality. It means what? If we would have identified ourselves with the false reality, if you deny that original reality, you become false. Though this Krishna is not using false, he says that it is not sat. Therefore, two words are introduced in these words. Sat and Asat. These Sat and Asat, they were introduced in the beginning itself as Nityam and Anityam. But he brings here, particularly, purposefully he brings here these two words because it has got the meaning. Sat means that which exists. Sat means that which has got existence. Okay. That which exists means, exist means what? It is. Asat means what? That which doesn't exist at all. Means what? It appears as though it exists. The one reality which exists, which is endowed with real existence, the another which is endowed with false existence. Now you see, every one of us, we experience about two realities. So one is false, one is truth. These knower of truth, they are well versed. They have understood, realized very well about this, the truth, the fact of this both reality. Now everything is shaken. Our ahankara, which is identified with ourself, it's false. False means what? It has got a temporary existence. It keep changes. It keep changes means it appears as though it exists, but it keep changes its reality. That is what the nature of this. It keep changes. That's what its reality is. So one is not changing at all. Another, it keeps changing itself. And this asat, which is known as the anityam, anatma, that depends on atma. That's what Krishna is bringing now. That's what, in between these two reality, this one reality called anatma, which is nothing but ahankara and body, mind and sense complex with the worldly object and experience all together, they are false reality and which are endowed or dependent on the real reality. You become very much, if you understand, you know, you will be shaken. Therefore, Krishna himself, he explains more by forthcoming verses. The next words, he explains it. What is Sat? That which has got existence. That existency, only it belongs to Sat. Another one doesn't have existence. Therefore, Sataha Bhavaha Vidyate. Asataha bhavaha na vidyate. Bhavaha means existence. The existence of Sat alone, true existence. The existence of Asat, anatma, anityam, is endowed with false existence. That's what the meaning of that words. In the next words, he explains what Sat, that which exists. Why it exists? Let us read. Avinashito tad vidhi yena sarvamidam tatam vinasham avyayasyasya na kaschit kartum arhati. Tad vidhi, realize. It has to be realized. What? That Sat which is avinashi, which never undergoes to a destruction. Yena sarvam idam tatam, by which everything is pervaded. And vinasham avyayasya asya, avyayasya vinasham nakaschit kartum arhati. You cannot destroy that reality which is called Sat. Now this is a valid tablet for Arjuna. What he said, I will kill all those people, they will die, therefore what? I will get papa. But now Krishna has cleared his doubt. Every one of them have two reality. One reality is the fact which exists. Another reality, whether you kill or not, it will keep changing. Now the subject matter is not completed. Therefore, we need not to apply immediately there. From the standpoint of Arjuna, we have to observe the complete teaching. Now there are many words, avinashi, and tatam, idam, tatam means all pervasive. Now Krishna is bringing more in-depth knowledge. The I which exists in me, called Atma, it pervades all over the body. Not only that, it pervades all over the creation. It's we need more time for this verse. Therefore, we will deal with this verse tomorrow in the next episode. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Hari Om.